Have your Bibles this morning, go over to Isaiah 61. We're going to read some really good scripture there today. Isaiah chapter 61. Very familiar to some of you. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Amen. It's going to compliment what God is doing here this morning. Amen. Turn to the person you're next to and give them a great big smile. Give them the, come on, just show them your pearly whites. Now you feel better? All right. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Amen. I found out not too long ago that a smile on your face does something to your body. That when you smile, it releases the feel-good chemicals of the brain and your body. Just makes you feel better. Amen. And it's a funny connection because the brain communicates to the mouth and the mouth communicates to the brain. So when something happens that makes you feel really good, you just automatically smile. But the vice versa is also true. You can smile and your brain thinks everything is fine, you feel good, and it'll do the same thing. And so you can fool your brain sometimes into thinking that you feel better than you really do. Amen. But it feels good to smile, doesn't it? Amen. Smile is a wonderful blessing from the Lord. You have a reason to smile today because God is for you and not against you. God's intention is for you to just go over, not under. Come on, somebody. Hallelujah. God is on your side. If God is for you, then no one can really stand against you. They can try. Amen. They can put up a good fight. They can make you one for a little while pause. But when you remember who's on your side and who is for you, you're on the winning side, praise God. Amen. The Hebrew writer said, what can separate us from the love of Christ? Tribulation, peril, nakedness, or sword? No, but in all these things, we are more than conquerors through Jesus Christ who loves us. Amen. We win. Hallelujah. Amen. And so it's a wonderful thing to know that we are planted by God. Amen. We are planted of the Lord. Amen. Tell your neighbor now. Tell him, John, planted. Come on, tell him. Tell him all the authority you can do right now. Say, I'm planted. Hallelujah, I am planted. I am planted, I am planted. Amen. Amen. God plants us in His kingdom. God plants us in His family. God plants us in His church. God plants us, amen, in relationship. We are the planted of the Lord. Glory to God. The intention in God's mind is for our roots to go deep into those living waters. Amen. Below the surface, amen. God doesn't want us to be surface Christians. He wants us to be deep-rooted Christians. Can somebody say amen? Amen? He wants us to be deep-rooted. And that's the intention of God's plan in your lives for each and every one of us. He wants his roots to go deep into the soil of his word. Praise the Lord. So that when the storms come and all the things beat against our lives, we're going to make it through. Praise God. This is what Isaiah begins to prophesy to those who love him, to those who walk under the anointing of his power. God promised us to be deep-rooted, planted people. Glory to God. Amen. Amen. And we are deep-rooted, planted people as we stay under the covering of His Holy Spirit. Of course, this is a prophetic utterance that the prophet spoke almost 700 years before Jesus Christ showed up on the scene. Oh, you remember the story when Jesus went back to His hometown. He'd been baptized in water. He'd been 40 days of through trials and fastings. The devil trying to get Him to give up before He ever got started. That's a good word right there. Some of you need to hear that. The devil will try to get you to give up before you ever get started. He tried it with Jesus, and so he's going to try it with you. He tries to get you discouraged and give up before you ever get started. But when you are walking with the Lord and anointed of the Holy Spirit, amen, you just tell the devil the same thing Jesus did. Get behind me, Satan. Yeah. Hallelujah. You know where the devil belongs? He belongs under your feet. Yeah. Glory to God. Yeah. Just put him under your feet and stomp on his head right now, praise the Lord. Just say, that's where you belong, Satan. Right under my feet. I got authority over you. Amen. In the name of the Lord. But Jesus went back after that 40 days of temptation in the wilderness. He went back to Nazareth, to his hometown, the place where it all began. Sometimes it's good for us to get back, amen, to the basics of where we started everything, amen. And go back and remember the good things that God has done. The testimony of the Lord, praise the Lord, will strengthen your life. When you think about what God has done and how good God is, it'll give you the strength to go on. I wish I had some help in here right now, amen. Amen. In the end of the book In the book of Revelation, it says, we overcome the wicked one by the blood of the Lamb and by the word of our testimony. What is our testimony? It's remembering all the good things that God has done. God is faithful to his people. He will never leave you nor forsake you, but he'll see you through all the way. Say, all the way. Hallelujah. He'll see you through all the way. He has a plan, a destiny, a course that he has placed your feet on. Praise the Lord. It's called the place that the righteous live. The place where the righteous are going. The place, amen, a direction, a destiny, that great plan of God that he wants to fulfill in our lives. He'll do it as long as you hold on to the hand of the one, amen, who created the waters. The one, amen, who spoke life into existence. Praise the Lord. The light of the world, the salt of the earth, Jesus Christ, amen. There's nobody like him. Amen. He'll never fail you. Amen. He is God and he cannot fail. Hallelujah. Jesus took this scroll on that day in Nazareth. He went into the synagogue. He began to open up the scroll to Isaiah 61, 700 years before the prophetic word, or after the prophetic word was spoken by the prophet Isaiah, began to read this word. We're going to read it today because this word that we're reading today, even though it was a fulfilled prophecy of Scripture, it's a word right now, word for you and me. Say right now.
Amen.
That's what rhema word means, a right now word. Praise God. It's wonderful to know the Bible. It's wonderful to take the word of God and apply it right now. Say right now.
Amen.
Hallelujah. It'll help you today. It'll help you this morning. It'll cause you to get up in the day and cause you to look a little bit different than you look coming in. Praise the Lord. Amen. Isn't it wonderful to come to Harvest Fellowship and go out looking better than you came in?
Yeah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Some of you needed help today. Glory to God. Glory to God. Say, oh me, Pastor. Hallelujah. Amen. But it's a good thing to know that when we apply the Word of God right now, amen, there is no devil in hell that can resist the Word of God. Amen. That's how Jesus defeated the devil. He said, it is written, Satan. Amen. You shall not tempt the Lord thy God. He put him in his place. Some of you today need to put the devil in his place and realize, I'm tired of you harassing me. You might have put a big root down here in the middle of our church, but guess what? It's not going to stay. Because the prophet said, amen, the axe is laid to the tree. Glory to God. We're going to just throw that thing back in the fire from where it came, and we're going forward. Hallelujah. Glory. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I'm not scared, and neither should you be, because all power is given unto us through Jesus Christ over all the power of the enemy. Amen. You can rise up in your home. You can rise up in your business. You can rise up in your city. You can rise up, praise God, in the church and say, not so, devil, get thee behind me. Because greater is he that's in me than he that is in the world. That's the truth right there. Praise God. And so Jesus took this scroll, he opened it up, and he began to read these words. It says, that the Spirit of the Lord God is upon me. That's the anointing of the Holy Spirit. That's the presence of Almighty God. Say, Almighty God. You know what you're saying when you're saying Almighty God? Almighty God. Almighty God.
Yes.
What you are saying, amen, is that you are serving a God that can do anything. He is Almighty.
Yes.
There's a lot of people, a lot of plans, a lot of spirits that think that they have power and authority, but they're not anywhere close to the Almighty God. Hallelujah. And that Almighty God is on your side. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. You feeling harassed? You feeling down? You feeling depressed? You feeling defeated? Amen. Just shake yourself a little bit this morning and say, wait just a minute, soul. I've got to remind myself that who is on my side? Who is on my side? Amen. Almighty God is on my side. There's nothing that he cannot do. Amen. And so he begins to read the scroll from the prophet Isaiah. And where it all started in Nazareth. He was born, amen, in Bethlehem. He was raised up in Nazareth, where it all began. Praise God. He's come full circle. He takes the book of the scroll there as the teachers and the Pharisees are watching him, and he begins to read these words. And he says, the Spirit of the Lord God is upon me because he hath anointed me. Glory to God. Amen. That's a good word right there. He's anointed me to preach good news. He's anointed me to preach good news unto the poor. It says here, the meek. He has sent me to bind up the brokenhearted, to proclaim liberty to the captives, the opening of the prison doors to them. Oh, I'm getting started here. Somebody, amen. Glory to God. To proclaim liberty to the captives, the opening of the prison to them that are bound, to proclaim the acceptable year of the Lord and the day of vengeance of our God. Amen. Hallelujah. Somebody's going to be in trouble. They're hurting you, harming you, talking about you, doing something mean to you. The day of vengeance of our God is rising up for you. Come on, somebody. Hallelujah. To comfort them that mourn in Zion, to appoint, to make a plan. Hallelujah. To give you something. To give to them that mourn in Zion, to give them beauty for ashes. Oh, there's a transfer taking place. There's a change being made in the house of God right now. Somebody say, right now. Hallelujah. He's going to give you beauty for ashes, the oil of joy for mourning, the garment of praise for the spirit of heaviness, that they might be called what? Trees of righteousness. The planting of the Lord, that he might be glorified. Hallelujah. There it is right there. The Bible says that Jesus shut the book. They all began to look at him. He said, today, this scripture is fulfilled in your ears. Somebody needs, praise God, clap their hands right now and say, today, hallelujah, this scripture is fulfilled in your ears. We're not saying that we are Jesus, but we are saying, amen, that there's something that Jesus accomplished when he said, today, is this fulfilled in your ears? Because that same anointing that Jesus walked in, that oil of gladness, that pouring out, praise God, of joy upon our life, the taking off the heaviness of our life of sin and disappointment and despair has been transferred. He's given us a garment of praise. He's given us beauty for ashes. He's given us a release of an anointing from on high. And the same anointing that was on Jesus is the power that I have, I give to you. Glory to God that you can go forward as the planting of the Lord and lift up your hands and realize today that I am on the winning side. Hallelujah. I am not going to tolerate anything less than God's best. Hallelujah. How many want God's best? Hallelujah. I am not going to settle for less than God's best and God's intention, God's proclamation, God's plan, God's destiny, God's prophetic word over your life is to do you good. Hallelujah. Amen. To bless your coming in and your going out. Your business is going to prosper. I don't care what it looks like. I don't care what they say. Amen. God said, amen. It's not over. I'm going to turn the situation around. Get up. Get up. Come on, stand to your feet right now. Get up all around this church. Praise the Lord. We're going to do a prophetic act right here. I want you to just turn around. Turn around. Come on, turn around. This is our time. It's our day. We are headed for a turnaround. Glory to God. Glory to God. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. God is saying, I am going to give you a turnaround. We are in a turnaround season. Why? Because the Spirit of the anointing has been poured out. Hallelujah. The anointing of God changes everything. There have been people, amen, have been going through it. This week was a hard week for some of you. I was a part of some of the situations that you were facing this week. And we're not going to deny the reality that we've been through a hard time. Amen. Amen. Jesus said, you will have tribulation in the world. We're going to go through days and times of trouble. Those things are just part of our life. But praise God, we're going through. He didn't call us to be building a house there. And we're just going through that time. Hallelujah, but we are in a turnaround season. Glory to God. And so the hard time has come. And we feel down. We feel down. We feel discouraged. We feel depressed. We feel mad. We feel a lot of heavy things on our life because of the situation. The way it looks like. It's always about what it looks like. Turn to your neighbor and say, it's always what it looks like. Come on, tell them. It always seems what it looks like. But God says that's not what it is like. Hallelujah. And he begins to take the idea, the truth about the anointing, the presence of the evidence of his presence. He is the anointing. Yes. Hallelujah. That will change everything in just a moment in time. He tells us in Isaiah chapter 10 and verse 27 that that yoke, a yoke was that thing that bound those oxen together, that had them clamped down, that had them going the way that the owner wanted them to go. The devil is a slave driver. Yeah. And the world is not your friend. Yeah. Hallelujah. And there are slave drivers who move you this way, and you get heavy under the circumstance. But in Isaiah chapter 10 and verse 27, God says, I've got a remedy. I've got a plan. Look up. Amen. And realize today that I'm sending my presence. I'm sending my anointing. I'm sending the answer to your need, and the answer is my anointing. Because it says in Isaiah chapter 10 and verse 27 that the yoke is destroyed because of the anointing. It's not just broken off of your life. Praise God, it's destroyed that can never come upon your life again. I wish I could get someone, like two or three people, ready to raise their hands right there and say, it's over for you, devil. It's over for you. I call back the blessing of the Lord in my life. I call back the blessing of the Lord in my family. I call back the blessing of the Lord on my business. I call back the blessing of the Lord in my church. I call the blessing of the Lord back in my health. I call the blessing of the Lord back in my mind. Glory to God. I wish somebody would shout it, God. We're in a turnaround season. Glory to God. We are in a turnaround season. He begins to understand and show some things. He said, the anointing was there, praise the Lord, to give you the good news. I'm giving you good news right now. I'm telling you what God has intended for your life. What God has said. Amen. If it was what Pastor Kim said, you could take it or leave it. We just don't know how that thing's going to work out. Amen. Because I'm only a man. For our God is not a man that he can lie. All of the promises of God are yes and amen. Something looking hard, you hear something sounding bad, you lift up your head and set your gaze on the hills from where your help comes from. My help does not come from the north, nor from the south, nor from the east or the west. My help comes from the Lord. And he is the one, hallelujah, that can change everything. Glory to God. He begins to cite some things concerning the anointing of God. He wants to set us free. He wants to walk out, praise the Lord, with a newfound hope in our heart, a new focus and vision in our eyes that God is good and God is going to work it out. Hallelujah. He is going to work it out. He said the anointing came to give the good news. Get our minds right. Get back in alignment with what God has said. Amen. Heaven and earth will pass away, but his word will not pass away. His word is forever settled in heaven. Praise God. It becomes important for us to align ourselves with what God has said. That's what Jesus did. Amen. As he began to get tempted and tried by the devil in the wilderness, he just kept coming back to what the Father had said. He just came back and refocusing on the purpose for his life. He knew that God had a plan and a vision and a destiny for his life. And God has a plan and a vision and a destiny for your life. It becomes important for us to get under the flow, amen, under the alignment of what God, the open heaven, is declaring for your life and walk in it. Glory to God. Glory to God. Amen. So he begins to highlight some things. He begins to talk about, amen, the brokenhearted. Yes, people go through things and they're bruised in the heart and things have happened that has brought discouragement. But the anointing today, say today.
Yeah.
Amen. The anointing today is going to fix that hurt. It's going to fix that hurt if you'll let him. Hallelujah. It's going to fix that. It's going to, the healing balm of Gilead wants to come and just flow into your heart. Praise God. He'll turn it around. Amen. You'll get up from this place victorious. You'll leave this place, amen, with more than what you came in with. Because God said, amen. God said his anointing will heal the brokenhearted. Amen. He'll open up the prison to those that are bound. I've been talking and investigating and counseling and calling pastors and talking to people. And I've never seen a day like today where there's such a heavy attack and assault on people's minds. I'm talking about Christians today. Amen. And they're overwhelmed with life. Amen. We are in an epidemic anxiety. We are overwhelmed with the epidemic of anxiety. And people are having nervous breakdowns. But the Lord says in Luke chapter 21 that as we get closer to that day, the pressures of life are going to be compounded upon people. Amen. So many people's hearts will fail them because of fear. But I'm here to declare this to the church today. God has not given us a spirit of fear.
Amen.
And He's given us power and love and a sound mind. And I declare the word of the Lord today that if you'll receive it, praise God, here right now will release an anointing upon your mind to cause you to be reminded, amen, that God is for you. And when those tormenting thoughts and those things of overwhelming feeling begin to try to come and overwhelm your life to lay you out, remember God. Capacity is re-energized as we refocus, praise the Lord, and get still before the Lord and begin to call out to God and say, Lord, you are my shepherd and I shall not want. Even though I'm going through the valley of transition, the valley of challenge, the valley of pressure, God has not left me. He's still the same yesterday, today, and forever. And the psalmist said, amen, that thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. And all of a sudden, there's a fresh anointing that begins to pour out. He says, He's anointed my head with oil, and my cup is overflowing. Praise the Lord. God wants to release His church today in a fresh anointing. He wants to overflow your life with joy and gladness and hope and vision and purpose. God, by His Spirit, wants to pour out a fresh anointing upon you today. Praise the Lord. That when you begin to feel overwhelmed, you just stand and see the salvation of your God. You be still and see what the Lord will do. You'll let the roots of your tree go down deep into the waters, the living waters that come only from God. Let the roots go down deep, amen, and you shall not be moved. Stand to your feet, stand to your feet, stand to your feet. Hallelujah. This is the intention, that this is the purpose of God. This is the conclusion. Say conclusion. Say it again, conclusion. This is the conclusion to the word of the Lord. As we get down to the end of this context, God has a conclusion for our lives. Amen. He's already been where you're at. He knows where you're going. He's already been there. And He's declared a conclusion over your life. Struggling with anxiety and fear, loneliness, health, all kinds of things that we wrestle with in this life. Struggling with all these things, God has declared a conclusion to the matter over your life. Lift your hand upright all around the place. This is the conclusion for you. This is God's word of conclusion to you. That you shall be called trees of righteousness. The planting of the Lord. That He might be glorified. Father, today, we thank you for our good work. God, a fresh anointing that you are pouring out. People coming out of despair, hopeless, helpless. Lord God, searching, praying, crying. Lord, all of those that have been tormented in their mind, troubled in their soul. Right now, we pray that release of fresh anointing. Holy Spirit, bear witness to this word right now. The Spirit of the Lord God is here to confirm His word.